Okay, now let's just take a look at the practical of layout views and event handling. So I'm going to create a new project for that. Name it views and events. I'm going to create an empty activity, and the name of my main activity will be main activity, and the XML file will be activity underscore main. Let the Gradle build the project. Okay, once the Gradle has been built, we can design our UI now. So for this particular application, I will be making my title as UI and events, and I will be changing my attributes here. So this is the way you design your UI with layout editor, which we just saw in our slides. So you can drag another UI, let's say a button, or you can drag another text view and keep it anywhere or place it anywhere you want on your layout. So if you check out the component tree right now, the root layout here is relative layout, and inside relative layout there are two text views. One I have already defined as title, another one I have just dragged and dropped. So this first one, you can always give the ID like my title. It's a good practice to give the ID to all your UI components. So the second one is again another text view. Now you can always go ahead and change the properties of this text view also. So you can always go ahead and change the properties from the right pane, and there you will find all the properties to change. Take any screen size, maybe 30 SP or 36 SP. Like we discussed, for text views or for font size, we will be using scaling pixel. Or you can always go to the coding part. This is the design part, layout editor. If the second part is your coding part. If you go to the text part here, you will see that you can even decide all the attribute from here. Let's say I want to change the color. Android text color. And I want to use a color which is already defined in my color resources. So you see, from your text part also, or from your XML part also, I can actually change my views or change my properties of views. So here now I will change it your text. Your text. Now here, what exactly my example gonna do? I will put two buttons here and call it change one, and I will put another button and let's just call it change two. And on the click of both of these buttons, my text view is going to be changed. Now, before I define my click listeners to that, let's just define the IDs to these views. Like I told you, it's a good practice to define IDs to each and every view, because if you want to use these views later on in your Java file, you can always do that. So in the ID of this text view, I will put it T1. Press yes. In this button, I'm putting B1. And in second button, I'm giving B2. So the first button I will be handling with my Java way, that is my coding way. The second one I will be handling with my XML way. We just saw that there are two ways to handle the buttons or on click listener or the click event. So we are gonna see both of them. So first, when I want to handle my button with coding part, I will come to my Java code and I need to change my text view. So I need to get the access of my text view. For that, I will create a text view reference, and I know my click listener or my event will be generated from a view known as button. So I will be needing the button reference also. Then to refer these views directly from your XML file, I need to use a method named findViewById. So findViewById, it returns me an object form. So I need to typecast it to text views. So how do I get the access of that same text view? For that, we have r.java file, and we will do r dot, because it's id, so r dot id dot t1. And now this t1 or this text view is referring to this same text view. So that's what our goal is, to refer exactly the same text view which you have defined in your layout. In the same way, I can refer to the same button also by defining button. Find view by id r dot id dot b1. After that, next, when we are doing it with coding, I need to put a listener to listen that, because as of right now, there is only an event source, that is button. So to put the listener, I need to do implements on click listener. And please make sure that you are putting on click listener of view class, not the dialog interface class. That will be covered when we reach to the dialogs. So view.onClickListener class, and it will give you error because onClickListener is an interface, and interfaces in Java have set of abstract methods which you need to implement. So when you click on this balloon, red balloon, and it will give you all the abstract methods which are there in this particular interface. You just have to press OK and those methods will be implemented for you. So now there is a listener, there is a handler, but still you need to register your event source with your listener. That is, you need to register your button with your listener. So how do you register? Set on click listener and put this. Now this here means that you're handling this particular listener inside this class only, inside this main activity only. That's the reason I'm putting this here. Now, all I need to do now is to put the code to change your text view inside your onClick handler. That is, so how do I change my text view? So I have the reference of text view T1. All I need to do is set text and put the name, put whatever the text you want. You clicked button 1, and that's it. So now if you run this application, with your emulator, it will look exactly the UI you have designed for your main application. And this will have two buttons, but the second button will not work right now because you haven't really given any listeners, or you haven't really handled your second button. But your first button, if you click on your first button, see here, you clicked button 1. So that's it. You have handled your first button. Now let's just take a look how exactly we can handle my click events in an easier way. So we just saw the Java way. Now let's just talk about the XML way. So in XML way, all you have to do is just click on your button and press control and click on that, and it will transfer you to your coding part. And inside that, all you have to do is just put an attribute name on click and give any name, maybe do something. It can be do task. It can be change text. Whatever you are putting here, whatever the function name or whatever the name you are putting here, just copy this name and put the same name inside that activity where you are using this layout. So the signature of that function will be public void do something and inside that, the attribute will be view. And inside this now, you can handle this button separately. Now set text, you clicked button 2. So you see, now you don't need a listener, you don't need to give an ID or get the access of button. everything has been taken care by this particular onClick attribute. So now if you run this, this button also has been handled by the way of XML. So if you click on change 2 now, it will show you click button 2. If you click on change 1 now, it will show click button 1. So that's how you handle your events and UI.